Hi Aquarius, Aquarius Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, welcome to your daily energy reading. Let's find out what is happening in your energy currently. Aquarius Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, what is happening in Aquarius's energy at this point? Aquarius Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Aquarius Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Aquarius Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Aquarius Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Let's find out what is happening in your energy at this point. Holy Spirit, my angels, my guides, my ancestors. We are starting with the Ten of Swords. You could have been in a relationship here, Aquarius, or a partnership. But there's this energy of betrayal with this Ten of Swords. Someone betrayed you badly here, Aquarius. But Tens are also about completion. So the ending of a difficult situation is here. I'm also getting that you are healing and you are walking away from whatever that pain it was that you were holding on to here, Aquarius. And then we have the Seven of Swords underneath here. I'm just picking up this heavy Seven of Swords energy. The energy of a very deceitful, lying, conniving kind of a person. You're dealing with a trickster here, Aquarius. Let's get more information. We have the Tower. Something ended here abruptly that you were not expecting. This Tower energy is Aries energy and Scorpio energy. Some of you are dealing with Aries and Scorpio. We also have Aquarius, Libra, Gemini with this Ten of Swords energy here. Something ended abruptly. Please note that the Tower energy is there to destroy whatever is built on a false foundation. It's not there to destroy your life. So if it happens in your energy, Aquarius, it's because whatever it is that you were working on was built on a foundation that was false. That's why it has to be destroyed here. You are dealing with people that are very deceitful here, Aquarius, backstabbers. I see you healing yourself and walking away from those situations. And we have this Nine of Pentacles now, Aquarius. You are working on yourself, working on your money, working on your resources at this point, trying to gain some sort of like stability in your life, Aquarius, currently. Let's get more information. Holy Spirit, my angels, my guides, my ancestors. We have the Six of Cups. I see somebody that is missing you a lot with the Six of Cups energy. And then we have the Six of Swords. I see you moving on from very difficult situations, Aquarius. You have healed yourself. A very difficult situation is over. Now there's somebody that is missing you. This devil energy, someone that is quite obsessive with you. This person is obsessed with you. They are thinking about you a lot, thinking about the past, reminiscing on the relationship, the connection that you guys had and shared. And I see you now, you're working on yourself. You're working on building yourself. You're working on your independence with this Nine of Pentacles here, Aquarius. You're working very hard. And then we have the Three of Pentacles. Some of you could have like lost a job here with this Three of Pentacles coming right underneath the Tower. If you didn't lose a job, something stopped working here, Aquarius. You could have lost a job, you could have lost a business, but something stopped working with this Three of Pentacles showing up right underneath the Tower here. But with the Six of Swords right next to the Three of Pentacles, I see you moving on from very difficult situations and now wanting to work on yourself independently, Aquarius. You're very independent. And there's a lot of celebration in your energy with this Four of Wands. Four of Wands, Aquarius, this is 11-11 energy here. I don't know if you're able to see it here on this card. I'm getting a lot of alignment. You are now aligned with your destiny. You are aligned with who you are here, Aquarius. You're working on yourself, focusing on yourself here, Aquarius. And you're happy. I'm picking up an energy of you just like wanting to be happy currently, wanting to rejoice. I'm also getting that something could also involve a house, a home here with this Four of Wands energy here. Some of you could have been married. Some of you could be wanting to get married currently. Let's get more information. Holy Spirit, my angels, my guides, my ancestors. And then we have the Hermit here, Aquarius. Some of you were dealing with somebody that could have ghosted you. This person is now missing you with the Six of Cups right on top of the Hermit. And then we have this devil again underneath. And this is your overarching energy. There's a serious, heavy energy of obsession. Some of you are dealing with Capricorn energy here. This person is now wanting to take a leap of faith and come towards you because they are missing you. They are obsessing over you. This person is replaying events of what occurred between you and them. I'm also getting an energy of someone that could have hurt you. With this Ten of Swords, this person betrayed you, lied to you. And they're now having to replay those events in their head. How they made you feel. How everything was so painful and toxic with that devil energy. I'm getting heavy toxic energy here from your person, Aquarius. This is someone that is quite obsessive, a very toxic energy here. Some of you are dealing with Capricorn energy. We also have Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, and we have the Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. So we have all the cups, all the energies here. And then we also have the Hermit. The Hermit is Virgo energy showing right underneath the Six of Cups. So this is somebody that is currently like, you know, trying to find answers within here, Aquarius. I'm also getting that this could be your energy where you're isolating. You're trying to discover more about yourself. And this person is thinking about you and missing you here, Aquarius. This is someone, you were dealing with someone that could have been like a ghoster. This person could have ghosted you. This person could have ended things with you with no explanation. Something just stopped working with this tower energy that I'm picking up here. Or this could have been you where you decided to walk away from somebody because of the heavy betrayal, the painful things that were happening in this connection here. Something that was very toxic. And you decided to cut your losses here so you can work on yourself with this Nine of Pentacles here. You're working on your money here, Aquarius, working on your independence, liking and loving the fact that you are free and you are alone at this point. Tell me more. What is this Ten of Swords for Aquarius? And then we have the Five of Pentacles. Someone could have left you out in the cold, Aquarius, with this Five of Pentacles energy here. This person could have betrayed you, left you out in the cold. Take it as it resonates. This could be you or your person. And we have this Three of Cups energy here. I'm also getting heavy third-party interferences in this connection. Somebody definitely did leave someone out in the cold. You could have decided to walk away from someone, and this person is feeling left out in the cold. Or this person could have decided to walk away from you here, Aquarius. And then now you're feeling, they left you feeling left out in the cold with this Five of Pentacles. They left you feeling very insecure, feeling like there was a lack, there was something missing in your energy here. You know, when someone just breaks up with you abruptly, especially if it's someone that you genuinely love, you have a tendency to feel like maybe you are not enough. With this Five of Pentacles, is giving me heavy insecurities here, Aquarius. Tell me more, Holy Spirit, what is happening in Aquarius's energy? And then we have the Page of Cups. This person has wanted to talk to you, Aquarius, sending you. They wanted to send you like an apology, romantic messages here. Like, but they're showing up as a page. They're still showing up in that emotional immaturity here. And it's coming right on top of the tower here. Something ended because somebody was quite emotionally immature here, Aquarius. I'm also getting an energy of confusion. Somebody felt like they had multiple options here with the Seven of Cups energy showing underneath. Tell me more, Holy Spirit. And then we have the Fool, Aquarius. I see you just taking lips and lips of faith here, Aquarius, with this Fool energy right on top of the Nine of Pentacles. You're just like walking away, taking a leap of faith, Aquarius, trusting the universe, trusting yourself, trusting that everything works out for you. I see you living a very carefree life at this point, Aquarius, just really enjoying the journey and not really obsessing over the outcome of something. You're just really enjoying every part of this journey that you are on. And I'm getting that, Aquarius, you're going to be very successful with this Nine of Pentacles. I see you just like taking a leap of faith, trusting in the universe, trusting your higher self, and you're stepping into a lot of success with this Nine of Pentacles here, where you're going to be independent, where everything's just working out for you. What is this Nine of Cups for Aquarius? Six of Cups for Aquarius, Holy Spirit. And I did say Nine of Cups. I do get that, you know, wish fulfillment energy. The Nine of Cups is wish fulfillment energy. And then we have now have the Two of Wands. This person is now getting ready to come towards you. This person could be at a distance from you. You're dealing with someone that misses you a lot, Aquarius. And this person is wanting to come towards you with this Two of Wands. This person is now ready. They're now ready. They want whatever occurred in this connection. They are not ready to come towards you. They are now currently wanting to step into this energy of pursuing you here. And then we have this Hierophant. Some of you could have been married to this person, or there was talks about marriage. This person could be wanting to come and marry you. I'm getting a Taurus energy with this Hierophant here. Tell me more, Holy Spirit. Tell me more, Holy Spirit, my angels, my guides, my ancestors. What is happening in Aquarius's energy? And then we have the Six of Swords. It's clarified by the Six of Swords. I like it when this happens because this is a clarifier that you are actually moving to calmer waters, yeah, Aquarius. You are moving to calmer waters. When a card clarifies itself, that is a definite yes. Moving to calmer waters, wanting to move on. I'm also getting, Aquarius, you could be moving to calmer waters with regards to like your work situation. A relationship could have ended here that also left you financially stuck with the Five of Pentacles on top of the Ten of Swords. So that you could have been dealing with an energy, someone that was like also took your money. If you were married to this person, maybe there was a divorce where you had to like split your money with someone here, Aquarius. But there's an energy of like money loss with the Five of Pentacles here. If you didn't lose any money, Aquarius, Pentacles is also time, it's resources. You know, anything that you invested in a connection, whether it's not material, even if it's not like material stuff, this person made you feel like, you know, they left you out in the cold. Like, I'm getting an energy of you like giving so much and you were not receiving here with this Five of Pentacles energy here. Tell me more, Holy Spirit. And then we have the Queen of Cups. There's somebody that wants to work things out, wanting to collaborate. This person could be like a water sign, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, a very loving, compassionate energy here, Aquarius, on top of the Three of Pentacles. I'm also getting some of you could be meeting the love of your life at work here with this Queen of Pentacles, with this Queen of Cups on top of the Three of Pentacles. You could be meeting this person while you were at work. Let's get more information. And then we have the Queen of Pentacles. We have two queens, the Queen of Cups, the Queen of Pentacles here, Aquarius. This by Aquarius, someone could have also cheated on you with somebody from work here. They could have decided to give the cup of love, their emotion, their affection to someone that they work with here, Aquarius. And then we have this Queen of Pentacles right on top of the Four of Wands, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Something, you are celebrating something here. You're celebrating a win. There's a lot of stability in your energy. I've been getting that for the past month, Aquarius, that something is shifting in your financial situation. You have a lot of willpower, Aquarius. You're someone that is extremely resilient with this strength energy underneath. A lot of inner strength, resilient. You are extremely resilient. You see how you're stepping out of this Five of Pentacles energy after being betrayed. And Aquarius, that's why I always feel like, you know, tarot is a very good tool to use, especially when you're dealing with relationships. Because, you know, when you're heartbroken, it's very difficult to even work and make money. So it's very important that you find out who you're giving your heart to, if they are really worth it. And if tarot is a tool for you to use to be able to discover those things, it's amazing. I am also open to personal reading. I have currently opened my personal reading site. If you want to do personal readings, I'll leave the information on the description box. You can book your personal reading. I answer 10 questions and then I do a video like this that only you have access to. So the information is going to be on the description box. I feel like you need to know these things when you're dealing with people that you're giving your heart to. Even if you don't want to know anything about love, personal readings could also be tools that you use to find out about your financial life, what is coming towards you in terms of like your finances. Let me not waste any more time. I see you stepping out of this Five of Pentacles energy, Aquarius, because you've decided to take a leap of faith with regards to something here with this full energy. And whatever it is that you decided to do that is out of the norm, because this is not your... I'm also getting that this is not your comfort zone. You decided to step out of your comfort zone and trust the process, trust the universe, trust your higher self with this full energy. Something is pushing you to expand yourself, to step into the unknown here with this full energy. And that is going to bring in a lot of celebration with this Four of Wands and also the Queen of Pentacles. The Four of Wands is also the marriage card. Some of you could be getting married here, Aquarius, and it's going to bring in a lot of stability in your energy with this Queen of Pentacles. Whatever person you're going to be meeting that you will marry, this person will bring in a lot of stability in your energy with this Queen of Pentacles. Let's get more information for Aquarius. And then we have this High Priestess energy, Aquarius, right on top of the Hermit. I see you using your intuition when you're dealing with situations, currently dealing with love situations, dealing with work situations. Your intuition is extremely heightened, Aquarius. Trust your intuition at this point. Your spirit is open. I also see someone right now that has a very a highly activated third eye. So you are a seer. You're someone that sees. I see you as a dreamer with this high priestess energy, which is Pisces energy on top of the Hermit. You're someone that is introspecting, using your guidance from within. Somebody that is very spiritually trapped in. You could have went through an awakening here, Aquarius, where everything seemed like it was very dark, with this Ten of Swords, Five of Pentacles. There's a lack of everything, lack of love, lack of stability. Some of you also had a lack of money. And this is currently coming to an end because you are stepping into your power, you're stepping into your spirit. You are trusting the guidance of yourself, your higher self, or you're trusting yourself within with this High Priestess and the Hermit. I see you doing a lot of introspection here. It's like you're silencing all the noises from outside and you're going within for the answers, because all the answers that you need are always inside of yourself. There's nothing outside of yourself that can be better than you, that knows you better than you know yourself. You will always need to go inside of yourself. And I see you going inside of yourself with this High Priestess and the Hermit, very spiritually tapped in right now. You're watching tarot. You're trying, you know that there's more to life, Aquarius. And you know that there's more to whatever situation this is that put you in this Ten of Pentacles, this Five of Pentacles and Ten of Swords energy here. So let's get more information, Aquarius. You get yourself a personal reading. I'm now open to personal readings. The information is on the description box. So get yourself a personal reading if you want a reading that is more directed towards you, because I do read for multiple energies. You might resonate with one part of the reading and not resonate with all parts of the reading. Okay. Aquarians in love, let's find out, how are they seeing you at this point? How is your person seeing you? How are they viewing you at this point? You could be thinking about this person. This person could be thinking about you. We have the Six of Cups again. This person is genuinely missing you, Aquarius. I'm getting heavy past life energy here. If this is somebody that is like your ex-lover, if it's not your ex-lover from this lifetime, this is like a past life lover. This could be a soulmate, a twin flame, someone that is yearning for you. You might not have met this person in this physical reality currently, but this is somebody that you know from lifetimes and lifetimes. If this is an ex-lover, someone that you know physically, this person misses you a lot. out with the Six of Cups that is showing up right now twice. Let's get more information. How are they seeing Aquarius right now? I'm also getting that this person knows that you miss them too. And then we have the Seven of Cups. This person could feel like you have multiple options here with the Seven of Cups. They could feel like there's so much on your plate. They could feel like, you know, you are a high commodity at this point. People are pursuing you. You have too many options with the Six of Cups, Seven of Cups right next to the Six of Cups. This person could also feel like you're still a little bit confused about where you stay, where you want to go in terms of the relationship that you guys have. How are they seeing Aquarius at this point? And then we have the Ten of Swords. This person knows that they hurt you, but they see that you're picking up whatever it is. You are healing yourself with tens of completion. They know that a difficult situation that they have put you in is not currently over. You have walked away from whatever hurt. The Ten of Swords is a very painful betrayal energy here. And when it's there at the Ten of Swords, it's like you are done. You're done feeling sorry for yourself. You're done mourning this person's loss. You have taken all the jabs. You have taken all the daggers that were directed towards you, and you're stepping out of this energy and you are now walking away from this person. They see you healing. They know that you have healed from whatever it is that they put you through here. How are they seeing Aquarius? And then we have the Seven of Swords. This person feels like Aquarius. This person, I feel like they're projecting their insecurities on you. The Seven of Swords is very sneaky energy. So they could feel like you're hiding some things. They could feel like you're sneaky or deceitful, but I feel like they're just projecting. If someone feels like if somebody knows that they're sneaky themselves, they're a liar, they're a player, it's very difficult for them to have healthy relationships because they feel like everybody does what they do here, Aquarius. And we have this Knight of Wands. This person could also feel like you're just like, you know, you're having a good time. You could be entertaining multiple people. You're just like, you know, you're a very hot commodity at this point. You're looking very beautiful. You're looking very attractive, and they are watching you. They could also feel like you're playing the field, like you're with other people here. And then we have the Three of Pentacles. This person could be watching you work. There's something that you're working on here, Aquarius. And this person could be watching you work on something here. You're just focusing on your work. They feel like you're very hardworking at this point. To have someone like you around them, you will make a lot. You'll be able to create a lot. You'll be able to work a lot together because the Three of Pentacles energy is that energy of collaboration. So this person feels like you are a team player here, Aquarius. And then we have the Ace of Swords, the card of truth. This person has realized something with regards to you, and they also want to talk. I'm also getting that this person feels like you're extremely honest. You are someone that is quite honest. You are cutthroat. That you are an S sign, Aquarius, you know. So that Ace of Swords energy is your natural energy. This person feels like you're quite honest. You are very direct. They would also feel like you want to talk about something here with this Ace of Swords. How are they seeing Aquarius at this point? We have the Two of Swords right underneath the Ten of Swords. This person, Aquarius, is like they are very confused when it comes to you here with this Two of Swords. I see this person is not really able to see you clearly. The fact that they even see you in the Seven of Swords, they know that they miss you, but they feel like there's someone you're entertaining currently. They don't know whether you've met someone else. It's like they're in the dark when it comes to you here. They don't know what the truth is when it comes to you. They're currently still in the dark when it comes to you. Let's get one last card. And then we have the princess of Wands, and we have the Devil. This person is obsessed with you, Aquarius. They are obsessing over you. They see you as someone that is extremely attractive in their eyes. You know, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. You are very fiery to this person. You are very you are very magnetic. There's something about you that draws people in, that draws this person into your energy. This person is extremely attracted to you. With this Devil, Aquarius, I'm getting that this person is heavily, heavily obsessed with you, with this Devil energy showing up again. It showed up at the bottom of your reading when I started. It's your overarching energy, and it's now showing up right now. This person is somebody that's very obsessed with you. This person thinks about you a lot. I'm also getting someone could also have addictions. This could be you or your person. There's an energy of addiction. The Devil energy is quite toxic. This person is holding on to you very tightly, Aquarius. Let's get more. Holy Spirit, my angels, my guides, my ancestors. Let's get more. I'm also getting with that Two of Swords I saw. I just feel like someone is struggling to communicate with you. I feel like someone has a blocked throat chakra. There's a lot that they want to say, but they don't know how to put it. They don't know how to say it. Tell me more, Holy Spirit. What is happening? And then we have healing heart, healing from heartbreak, freedom from toxic relationships or addictions. Aquarius, you're breaking, you broke free from this energy. You're breaking free from this energy. You're healing yourself. You are mending your broken heart. You've learned how to heal yourself. And I like that you have learned to walk away from things that are no longer serving you, because sometimes we can stay in these unhealthy, toxic relationships for some reason. So I see you walking away from whatever this energy is here, healing yourself, freeing yourself from this toxicity. And then we have X. Breakup, separation, stop the pattern, silent treatment and abandonment. This is Aquarius. I see you not wanting this person back. It's like you want to end this very badly. This could be you or your person. There's somebody that doesn't want the cycle to continue here. This could also be advice from your higher self that you need to stop the cycle. If this is a toxic relationship that you keep on going to, you might need to end this cycle and walk away completely from this person. Because when you are healing your heart, you see, Aquarius, you're mending your broken heart here. And then after you've made some progress, this person returns. It's like you stay in this pattern of like breakup, make up. It's like you're not going to be whole. You need to be whole. You need to fix yourself. You need to heal yourself. So if you're in a toxic connection that, you know, it's and breaks up, make up, break up, make up, it's not healthy for you, Aquarius. You might need to stop this pattern. And everybody has free will. I'm just here to give you advice. Please don't shoot the messenger. Let's get more information for Aquarius, Holy Spirit, my angels, my guides, my ancestors. Someone is also giving someone the silent treatment. Somebody is just giving somebody the silent treatment. This could be you or your person, where you're just ignoring. Then we have mask, not showing true feelings. This person, Aquarius, they could be pretending like they don't care. I get that energy. And we have the runner. That runner chaser relationship, some of you could be chasing. This person is a runner, Aquarius. Runner in a codependent relationship, fear of intimacy, listening to ego. There's somebody that is quite egotistical. I'm guessing that this person, Aquarius, is like they are masking their true feelings for you. This person knows that they love you. They pretend like they don't care about you here, Aquarius. This person act like everything is fine. They are moving on. They are happy with their lives. This person is a runner. This person has a fear of intimacy. This person has a fear of connections. They feel like they are not worthy of love here, Aquarius. Take it as it resonates. Remember, whatever it is that you chase will continue to run away from you. If you want this person back, I will just say that you must stop chasing them. Focus on other things. Go on dates. Meet other people. And when you least expect, they'll come back. And in most cases, when they come back, you don't even want them anymore because you've done the healing. You've moved on. So if you continue to chase somebody, they will continue to run away from you. So stop that pattern, Aquarius. Stop that pattern. So let's get more information. If you want to get a personal reading, like I did say, something that is more directed towards you, just get the information on the description box. Let's get more information. Holy Spirit, my angels, my guides, my ancestors. Let's get more. Holy Spirit, my angels, my guides, my ancestors. Tell me more about Aquarius and their person. We have the Two of Swords, the Two of Mirrors. Aquarius, this person wants to talk to you, but I feel like this person is still confused. They don't know what to say. That stalemate energy, like, you know, they feel stuck. I'm getting someone that has a blocked throat chakra. There's a lot of mental conflict in your person's energy. And then we have the Eight of Swords. You know, this person is in a loop when it comes to you. The Eight of Swords, the Eight of Mirrors energy in your head. This person, you leave this person's mind rent-free. This person is constantly thinking about you. You are stuck in their mind, Aquarius. The Eight of Swords is that mental, that self-imposed prison, the mental prison. This person constantly thinks about you. It's like thoughts of you are running around their head, like in a loop. They can't stop thinking about you. This person can't do anything but think about you. We have the Knight of Roses. Some of you could be dealing with a runner here, front runner. Some of you could be dealing with someone that loves to run. The runner energy keeps on showing up here. The Knight of Roses is the Knight of Wands. This person wants to come towards you, Aquarius. This person is very passionate when it comes to you with this Knight of Roses energy. They could be wanting to come towards you for passion, for passionate reasons, wanting to be physical with this Knight of Roses. This is the Knight of Wands energy here. This is somebody that is extremely attracted to you. Let's get more information. You see, we have the daydreamer energy, the page of cups. This person cannot stop thinking about you. This person daydreams about you. They think about you a lot here, Aquarius. Tell me more, Holy Spirit. You're stuck in this person's head. You live rent-free in this person's mind. And then we have the Nine of Pentacles energy, the influencer. You could be someone that is quite beautiful or you like to post on social media. This person could be watching you. The Nine of Pentacles energy is that single, independent energy, working on yourself kind of energy here. So you could be someone that is chasing your money currently, trying to have your life in order, working in your stability. You are posting very beautiful content on your social medias if you're someone that likes to post. Or there's just something about you. You're very beautiful currently. And I'm also getting that influencer energy. Even if you're not like a social media influencer, your friend group, some people around you see you as someone that is quite influential. They can get a lot of advice from you. You're someone that's hyper independent with this Nine of Pentacles energy here. You're not afraid to be alone. You're not afraid to work on yourself by yourself alone. You're not afraid to get your own stability here. You're not a very dependent energy. You're not depending on other people to come and nurture you. And it's like everything that you need is inside of you, and that makes you extremely attractive to this person. Even if this is not the case, Aquarius, this is how the person is seeing you at this point. Let's get more. Holy Spirit, my angels, my guides, my ancestors. And then we have the host. This is the Hierophant energy here. This person could be thinking about marriage. They could be thinking, the Hierophant is that marriage energy. This person could be thinking about marrying you, taking things seriously. And then we have destiny. Something is destined here. Something is destined to happen. This person also feels like it is their destiny to be with somebody like you. Then we have the Queen of Rings, the Queen of Pentacles energy. The single mom. Some of you could be single moms, single parents, single dads here with this Queen of Rings energy here. I'm also getting that someone could be wanting to send you like a care package. Like a care package, very beautiful energy that I'm picking up here. Your person sees you as somebody that's very nurturing, very loving here with this Queen of Rings. This is the Queen of Pentacles energy here. They could also feel like you have a lot of abundance and stability around you. Even if this is not the case, this is how your person is seeing you at this point. Don't shoot the messenger. I'm taking the energy as I see it. I am an energy reader. I'm not here to entertain anyone. I give you the messages as I see them. But this person feels like they are destined to be with you. It is their destiny to be with you here. And they are rushing. They're coming towards you with this Knight of Wands. This person is very passionate when it comes to you. They find you very attractive, Aquarius. If you want something that is more detailed and directed towards you, you can get yourself a personal reading, Aquarius. I'm open to personal readings because I'm getting so many requests. So I want to be able to give you guys information about your struggles or anything that you could be wanting to ask. Please note that when you purchase a personal reading, it might take like 3 to 4 days because I have so many things that I do. So I might be busy. You might not get it within like 24 hours. Just be patient. Holy Spirit, my angels, my guides, my ancestors. Tell me more about this energy in Aquarius. Finances, future, mind on the money. You are actually focusing on your finances, your stability at this point. The Nine of Pentacles showed up twice, Aquarius. Your mind is on the money. Your mind is on the price. You're trying to get stable. You're trying to build your finances. You're trying to build your stability. And the fact that this energy keeps on showing up, the universe is backing you up, Aquarius. You have a lot of backup. And the Queen of Pentacles energy, I saw it twice. There's a lot of stability in your energy. Whatever it is that you're working on, Aquarius, is going to multiply. I declare right now that whatever it is that you're working on with regards to your finances, you're putting so much work in it, it's going to multiply. There's a lot of success in your energy at this point because you're focused too much on money, you're focused on your success, on your stability, and that is exactly whatever it is that you focus on grows. That is exactly what will grow. Let's get more information, Holy Spirit, my angels, my guys, my ancestors. And then we have romance and feelings. Some of you are going to be falling in love. Some of you are going to be falling in love with someone new. I am getting a lot of money. I'm getting a lot of romance. And I'm getting that whatever it is that you're going to end up, whoever this person it is that you're going to end up with, whether it's your past person or someone new, this connection is going to bring in a lot of stability in your energy here. And then we have friends and influences. Someone could be influenced by their friends. A relationship could not be working out because somebody's listening to their friends here. I'm also getting that some of you could be falling in love with a friend. And then we have family and security. I'm getting a lot of security and stability from whatever relationship you decide to enter at this point, Aquarius. There's a relationship that is coming with a lot of stability, a lot of structure, a lot of money, a lot of love. Let's get more information for Aquarius. And then we have heartbreak and shattered. Aquarius, you're dealing with someone that is heartbroken. Wow, I see you working on your money, working on yourself. You know, you're attracting new love, or you have attracted a new lover. Things are looking out for you. You're feeling very great about yourself. You're very loving people around you. Family is, everything is beautiful around you. If this is not happening in your energy right now, this is yet to come. A very structured, a very solid, a very secured kind of like a relationship that's going to bring in a lot of stability in your energy. It's filled with laughter and romance and beauty. I'm also getting, Aquarius, you're going to feel like your partner is your friend. You know, when you marry your friend, is the best kind of relationship. And whoever you're dealing with is feeling heartbroken and shattered. I'm also getting someone that could be drinking themselves here to death, drinking some wine, trying to, like, you know, mend their broken heart. And then we have storm turmoils coming ahead. This person that you're dealing with is going through it currently, Aquarius. They are facing, they're going through heartbreak after heartbreak, disappointment after disappointment. There's a lot of tower moments in your person's energy at this point. While everything is looking out for you, you have done the healing. The Ten of Swords is an ending of a difficult cycle. And now you're about to attract everything that you ever dreamt of, everything that you ever wanted. And you're dealing with someone that is currently going through it. Even if you're, you know, it's so difficult when you watch somebody that you used to love go through a lot of difficult situations. I understand. But Aquarius, you are allowed to be happy. If you're dealing with someone that left you in a very difficult situation, broke your heart, hurt you, left you very broken, Aquarius, it's okay for you to be happy and move on from whatever the situation is. So this person that you're dealing with is just not, it's currently, it's like they are suffering. They are not, like, nothing is going well. Oh, anxiety, worry. Oh, Aquarius, this person is feeling very anxious. They are worried, sleepless nights. Somebody could have anxiety problems. And then we have pain, agonizing pain and hurting. What? Ooh, Aquarius, you could have blocked this person, or this person could have blocked you. You see, the top of this reading, it's finances, mind on the money, future, romance, feelings, friendships, family, security. And then underneath is heartbreak, shattered, turmoil coming ahead, storms, anxiety, worry, pain, agonizing pain and hurting. Your person is going through it. The energy is not the same. The energy is not the same. Your energy is on a higher plane here, Aquarius. So everything is working out for you here. While whoever you're dealing with is going through the most. You are getting a lot of good karma, Aquarius. You're getting a lot of good karma. Please note that tarot is time fluid. Please come back to this video. I know that something is going to change in your energy. I can definitely feel it. This whole month, I've been feeling a lot of things happening for Aquarians. I am an Aquarian myself. I see a lot of changes coming in your energy that are bringing a lot of stability, a lot of beautiful romantic life, families, a lot of, like, beautiful families. I see a lot of beauty in your energy, a lot of structure, a lot of stability, a lot of security, love, romance, money. And then there's somebody that you're dealing with, Aquarius, that is going through the most. This person could have left you and everything just appeared as if, like, everything was going well in their life while everything was breaking and ending in your life. But I see you at this point, Aquarius. I see you healing. You have healed from whatever that pain was. That Ten of Swords energy. You've decided to stand up and walk away. You're no longer feeling sorry for yourself. You have accepted the betrayal. You have accepted that everything is, it ended and it's perfectly fine. I don't see you still holding on to that pain. Even though you might still think about that person because you did love them. But I don't see you holding on to that pain. I see you letting go and walking away. Hence, everything is starting to look out for you in this next couple of months, in this next couple of weeks. Things are going to change in your energy. Major, major, powerful change in your energy. And as soon as that happens, Aquarius, please, I'll leave my email address. You can just say, hi, it happened. I just want to know. It makes me very happy when I get those kind of, like, messages from my subscribers, my viewers, from my community, that then they tell me that, yes, you are right. It happened for me. I am currently in a loving, happy relationship. I'm with someone that is available. I'm not confused. I don't have to be watching tarot. I'm in a very beautiful relationship. My finances are looking up. It's very beautiful, especially after difficult situations like these ones where you're dealing with somebody that is just not appreciating the energy that you are giving. This is very painful. Whatever it is that you're dealing with is currently going through a lot of painful, painful situations here, Aquarius. you gotta pray for this person. You're not obligated to pray, but I'm like, I'm just saying that something is just not right in your person's energy at this point. There's a lot of painful endings in your person's energy. If they were to send you messages, what would this person say to Aquarius? For Aquarius that care, if you still care what this person wants to say, let's get messages from your person. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Get yourself a personal reading. I couldn't give you like I wanted to because I'm still healing from my past. So you could have been dealing with somebody that was still holding on to past trauma, past relationships. And then we have, please unblock me. Yeah, that's me calling you from an unknown number. This person could be calling you from a number that is unknown. You could be wondering, who is calling me? Who is this number that keeps on calling me? They want you to know that is them. You could have unblocked, you could have blocked this person, Aquarius. I keep looking at your pics and not to mention the videos we made. OMG, I will never delete them. So you could have like made some content with this guy. You could have taken these pictures with this guy or this girl, this person. You could have taken like pictures together, created videos together. This person is still watching those things. I've been putting on a front. My life is not what it seems on the outside. We did get that mask energy. This person is definitely wearing a mask. Their life is not how they are portraying it. This person is pretending that everything is fine. They are happy. They could be pretending. They could even be pretending like they're in a happy relationship. If they moved on from you, everything is just going well in their life. They are lying, Aquarius. This person is wearing a mask. Everything is falling apart in your person's energy. This person is in a lot of pain. They are feeling it. They are feeling it. They're feeling a lot of pain here. And then we have, I love your swag. You are the whole package. They feel like you are the whole package, Aquarius. And then we have, I pretend like I don't care, but it's quite the opposite. My feelings for you are a little bit obsessive. Why did I say, Aquarius? That devil energy. And now they are confessing. They want you to know. They are obsessing over you. They're obsessing over you. If you need to protect yourself from this kind of energy, do that, Aquarius. Because you don't know how people act when they are obsessed. So I'm going to end your reading here, Aquarius. You can get yourself a personal reading on the description box if you want more information. I love you, Aquarius. Until I see you again tomorrow, I'll be posting on a daily basis. Thank you. Bye.